Hi friends, welcome to another video on Tally ERP 9. Today we are going to know how to create ledgers in Tally. First of all, open the company that you want to create ledgers. Then first you have to go to display. From there, click list of accounts. We have already seen that there are many groups here. This branch or division, capital account, all the names in bold letters are groups and others are ledgers. Here you have only two ledgers in Tally by default, that is cash and the last one profit and loss account. Only these two ledgers will be there in Tally by default. All the other ledgers you have to create by yourself. So let's see how to create that ledgers. Let's go back to Gateway of Tally. From there, click accounts info, then ledgers. Here you have two options. One is single ledger and other is multiple ledgers. When we studied about the group creation, we have studied the same thing. We said that groups can be created as a single group or multiple groups. In single groups, you can create only one group at a time. The same way, in the single ledger also, you can create only one ledger at a time. And in the multiple ledgers, you can create as many ledgers as you want at the same time. So first of all, let's look into how to create ledgers in single ledger option. For this, click create. Here I am going to give a ledger, that is HDL capital account. Okay, then you have to give the group name. Here HDL capital account is capital account itself, so I just keep entering. Inventory values are not affected. This is not an inventory account, so you have to keep it no. Then you can give the name and address. This option you usually do for the debtors and creditors. Okay, for capital account and all, this is not compulsory. Then if you want to fill all these details, you can give provide bank details and all. You can give the PAN or IT number. Then if there is any GST transaction between this party, then you have to give the GST number also. As of now, there is no GST numbers and all, so you have to skip these areas. And if you have any opening balance, like if you are carrying forward your accounts, then you will have opening balance, so you have to give that opening balance here. As of now, I am a new company. I just started. I don't have any opening balance. So I will keep entering and just press accept. My ledger is created. Let's see. Let's go back. To know whether the ledger has been created or not, you can go to display. There you can see a new ledger is created. That is HDL capital. I have already said that there will be two ledgers by default in Tally. That is cash and profit and loss account, that you can see here. And the ledger I have created is also listed here. Okay, in this way you can see your ledgers. Now let's go back, try multiple ledgers. In the multiple ledgers, we'll be creating more than one ledgers at a time. Let's see. Click on create. Here they're asking under group. Under group means there are many groups in Tally and you can create your own group also, that we have discussed in the previous lecture. If you are entering a ledger for a single group, then you can just select that group and just enter. Suppose if you are entering the name of sundry creditors, then you can just select that sundry creditors and create the ledgers for each sundry creditors, like ABC Limited. Okay, and you can give the names. But if you want to create multiple ledgers in multiple groups, then you have to select all items. Here the first ledger I create is ABC, that is sundry creditor, the same. There is no opening balance. If you have opening balance, you can give here. And the second ledger I am going to give is salary. Salary is a expense, so I just give indirect expense as a group. Then I just enter. Then one more ledger I'm creating, that is HDFC bank, that is bank account. These are the three ledgers I'm going to create. Now after finishing, you just please enter, then you can save it. Now if you want to know whether the ledgers are created, you can go to display, then click on all items. Then you can see all the ledgers that you have created, that is ABC Limited and the cash by default, HDFC bank. See, if you have created the ledgers in single or multiple ledgers, whatever way, all the ledgers will be displayed here in the multiple ledger display. Okay, so this is how you create multiple ledgers. Let's go back once again to single ledger display. There also you can see those ledgers which you have created in the multiple ledgers. That is ABC, HDFC, salary, all this you have created in the multiple ledgers, that you can see in the single ledger display also. So whatever way you create a ledger, it will be available throughout your Tally. Okay, now if you want to edit any ledger, then you can go for alter option there. If you want to select, then I select ABC Limited. Here I'm going to change the name of the party to XYZ Limited, and this is not a sundry creditor, this is sundry debtor. Okay, all these details I can change individually. So now ABC Limited is gone and XYZ Limited appears. In the same way, you can alter multiple ledgers also. At a time, you can edit as many ledgers you want in the multiple ledger alteration. Okay, this is how you create ledgers in Tally. Hope you all like my video. Please share and subscribe to my channel. Click on the bell icon for future notification.